Enter, Dimmi.
Dimmi?
Stranger, if you prefer. Lost one would be more exact.
Lost one?
You are a stranger because you are not from this place. You are lost because you do not recognize Muhammad as the prophet of Allah. But you are not damned because you pray to Allah, although you give him another name.
Did you know Hikmah well?
Hikmah? Yes. A young girl with as much faith as she has heart. She is demanding and impassioned, and funny. Such spirit. Almost too much spirit for a young girl, but plenty for a daughter of the governor. We were friends. Her father encouraged her to follow my lessons here.
Can you tell me about the Hebrew and Arabic alphabets?
The letters are holy signs. God used them to pass his word to man. Symbolically, they contain part of his strength. But there are surely those more knowledgeable than me to talk of this subject. I am thinking of Yusuf al-Bakri, the calligrapher who often works in the gardens.
Did you have a chance to talk to the prisoner?
Yes, he is a man full of paradoxes. Sometimes he was as wise as a patriarch, other times foolish as a child. Complex personality, but he knew how to make himself loved, even by his jailers, and he received visits from Hikmah, for one. I used to play chess with him. He was a great adversary.
Do you know what his faith was, and why he was so interested in this dagger?
That is a difficult question. He may have been motivated by a single desire to underscore that which unites the three religions of the book.
How did you play chess?
Through the bars of his cell. We had agreed that every time he won, I would bring him a book. He read a lot recently, and then afterwards he wanted me to get him something to write and paint with.
Who is Dimmi in this city?
The Dimmi are the people of the book whose faith is turned, like the Muslims, to the one and only God, even though they name him Yahweh, or God the Father. If they pay the jizya, a specific tax, they receive protection and the right to practice their religion on the condition that they do not commit an act of proselytism. Jewish, Orthodox Christian, Latin and Armenian Dimmis come to Jerusalem. I think that is all, but it is quite enough to make life a little complicated sometimes.
Tell me about Muhammad.
Our prophet, blessed be his name, was born in the year 570 of the time of the Nazarenes. He was an ordinary man, a camel driver, to whom the angel Gabriel gave the mission of being the last carrier of the word of God. Muhammad dictated the Quran under divine inspiration and moved the entire Arabic peninsula from idolatry to the worship of Allah. After his death in 632, the caliphs brought the flame of revelation to Andalusia and Persia. But that is another story.
What books did he ask you for?
The treatise on zoology by Ibn al-Mawzili, the treatise on optics by Al-Aytham, the Book of 100 Doors by Isaac Chani, the Pastor by Hermas, and even a conversion table for calendars.
Can you show me this conversion table?
It is somewhere on these shelves. It is a large book with a Latin title. Dimmi, You seem patient and not too foolish. I do not doubt that you shall find that which you seek one day.
And so, Secretary, have you decrypted this puzzling fresco?
Not yet, Governor, but I am applying myself to it.
Well, then go back and apply yourself some more, and return when you have something more conclusive to tell me.
I salute you, Master.
Ah, you must be the Nezirin translator. I have heard of you. Can I be of any help?
Could you tell me about the alphabets used by the Hebrews and Arabs?
The letters are energies. They are values and qualities, much more than just simple signs. But that is also true of the alphabet used by you, Rumis.
You say that letters are values also? But please, explain that to me.
The Hebrews brought this art of association up to a very high point of refinement. They call it the Kabbalah. It quickly became extremely complex, but it is a powerful tool for meditation. The basic practice involves associating each letter with its position in the alphabet. I have a plate here that illustrates how. Let me show you.
Did you have the chance to meet the madman who escaped?
Oh, no. But, strangely enough, I think he received a number of visits. Ibrahim, the Sufi Isa al-Ghari, and especially Hikmah, the governor's own daughter. May Allah protect her.
Do you know the venerable Sufi who studies in the library?
Isa al-Ghari? Oh, do not speak of him. Today, tomorrow, ever.
Oh, you're not on good terms, I take it.
On good terms? The day I finally beat him at chess, I shall perhaps manage to pardon him for being so intelligent.
Do you know that the madman left a strange drawing on his cell wall?
I saw that. It's nothing. In any case, it is not art.
Could you tell me a little about your art?
Tradition has it that the kalam, instrument of calligraphy, was the first object created by Allah. Whoever holds the kalam in accordance with the rules of proportion and harmony is, to some extent, closer to the secrets of God.
I keep bumping into these cartouches.
I have been thinking about that. The first symbol seems to stand for one of the three religions. The second is clearly meant to indicate a number. As for the third symbol, perhaps that is a date. But what is this madman trying to tell us?
I may have found something, but I need to look at a few documents.
Of course. What books do you want to look at? 111 surahs make up the Quran, my friend. Would you like to read one in particular?
Should not be there.
111 surahs make up the Quran, my friend. Would you like to read one in particular?
What?
I do not know in the Quran any better way of defining what is faith. The Gospels? Which one do you talk of? That of St. Matthew, St. Mark, St. Luke, or St. John? Love, the greatest of all gifts from God to man. The most difficult and demanding, too. The Torah, a generic term which stands for the five books famed for being written by Moses' very own hand. Genesis, Exodus, Leviticus, Numbers, and Deuteronomy. You must have a more precise idea of what you're looking for. Hope, the heart of the alliance between Hebrews and Yahweh, their God. And so, faith, hope, love. These are what the Christians call theological virtues. They are common to all three religions. You see, even if Hayat is mad, he certainly knows and masters all the diversity of the writings.
That's it. The cartouches stand for three words: faith, hope, and love.
Ah, yes. We have three boxes, three maps, and three words. I wonder if we have to find a way to place the words on the maps.
I think that your talent could help us to progress in our investigation. Could you write some words on a wall?
Well, I would do anything to please the governor and help find the girl, but I cannot see well from afar, and I've misplaced my glasses. Without them, I shall not be a great help to you.
The nest is rocking dangerously. If the glasses are inside, they may be broken. I've found your glasses. Now we can go to the cell. Look, Hyatt's friend has returned.
Something is attached to the bird's foot.
What does this triptych say to you?
Nothing.
These cartouches are in fact references to the three holy virtues that are common to all three religions.
This is the work of a holy man, not a calligrapher.
Do you see something in these maps?
No!
What do you think of these paths?
That our man cannot master a steady hand.
Do these lines mean anything to you?
Well, for me, they could also be dots.
Could you paint the words faith, hope, and love in the boxes?
Where? The boxes are enormous.
Keep close to the beginning and the end of the lines.
Let me see. Ah, yes, yes, I think you're right. It seems to fit.
Everything seems logical up to now, but the lines of each word could indicate a dozen different places. You're obviously missing a clue.
One element is missing, that is sure, but the solution must be near.
I would like you to place these crosses on the words that you have just written in the boxes. Look, the lines only cross the words in one place. Do they show particular places, Ozdemir?
The Holy Sepulchre, the place where the Son of Mary was placed after his crucifixion. The Tankizia Madrasa, one of the most important Quranic schools in Jerusalem. This indicates the Ramban Synagogue. It is time we warn the governor. Governor, my secretary has unraveled the puzzle. The madman indicates three places in Jerusalem. I fear that we are only at the beginning of what will be a long trail.
You seem to be gifted with wisdom, Secretary. I am taking a risk, but I trust you. Follow the signs, investigate, rummage, and interrogate. I bestow my honor as governor in your hands. Find Abraham's dagger for me. And above all, return to me that which is 1,000 times more precious than titles and duties. Return Hikmah, my daughter, to me.
Adrian, tell me, what were you looking for out there in the desert?
A woman that I had lost.
And here you are, looking for another lost woman. Allah wants to tell you something, my friend.
I'm afraid I had noticed.